welcome to another Ride Along with Goggles tutorial. And this time we're going to discuss advanced skinning using Mod Studio 2. And you might ask yourself, what's advanced skinning? And what happens is typically, I can open a simple skin template. I should have thought of that. Let's go Mod Tracks. We'll get a root of 389. And let's look at a PDN, new old school flat top PDN, that'll do. So, I must have made this one as a donor. It's not a good example. It's got everything on it all in one bad example. Let's grab something else. Let's use Hell Creek Ranch. This one's going to come out. Hell Creek Ranch 389. This will be a better example. I'll get rid of that other one. Don't save. So here, like you see, this is the way I do. This is the way I do a simple skin. So I've got all of the layers, a whole bunch of stuff. Some things didn't work out. I just blank them out. I'll take it out later. So for, there's the script layer. So you can see the script appear, disappear. I do it in layers because I can grab something, move it around without affecting anything else. So if I wanted to move that script layer, I could just go like this, or if I want to get all of it with the GBW there, and I can copy it, paste it, and I can drag that. Oh, I grabbed the template. Hang on. Just Alt-Z, and I'll go to script, highlight that. You don't have to undo that. Just go to where you want, copy, paste, and now I've got that on my, I can grab it and turn it around and put it somewhere else. Maybe I wanted to put it on the back of the cab. Who knows? There it is. So you can move it around. So he didn't affect anything else. And we'll just undo. Get rid of that. Like it never happened. So you get all these layers. And, I do things like here's a test layer of red to throw under things to see how it's going to look. And I don't print that out, obviously. Yeah, you can see things like the, what's that one called? Cow and calf, I think, right there on the tank and tank labels. You got a layer for everything. And then at the end of the day, you can do what you want with it. If you want to make it one file, you can. But what I like to do is leave it like this. So if I go and do another truck, I can come in here and I can grab something from here, a specific thing like drivers. So there's drivers right there. I can grab that, put it on another drawing, and kind of manipulate it till it gets where you want it. And you just grab things really easy, like stickers, on the door there. So you just grab them. And so anyway, that's a simple skin. That's how I do a simple skin. It's simple. And at the end of the day, when you're ready to turn this into something to put into Mod Studio 2, you just disable the background and save it as a DDS. So pretty handy. So let's kill that. We don't need that anymore. And we're going to look at, now we're going to do an advanced skin. So now when you look at this and you go, well, how is that advanced? There's nothing there. Well, it's because this is the truck body. And the truck body is one portion of the skin, of the overall result. And you've got a whole bunch of accessories. I'm not going to drag them all out. I'm just going to show you some. So here's the fuel tanks, for example. And so for this truck, I have the label on here. So that's the labels for the the fuel label that's on the tank. Has the specs and capacities and certifications and everything on it. And so I just leave that enabled and I use it on all the tanks. So this is new old school tank.pdn. And if we went to the folder where these are, there's a tank one. So there's tank and tank one. They're two different sizes. And we don't really need to go into that level of detail, but you'll see when, let's look at the, see if we can bring that up. Let's go. Mod Trucks, Peterbilt 352. And so in here, let's just make this big. So you see it, we got all these different tanks, new old school tank one PDN, and there's the plain tank, and you can see how it's a different orientation. So let's just bring that up and we'll show you. And so here's, what do we got here? Oh, it's still coming. This old PC, I'm telling you, I got to save up. The motherboard blew up a few months back, and I put a really good motherboard in it. And it's due. I need to save up and buy a proper chip for it, a processor, get it going. Anyway, here's, this is tank one, and this is tank two. So you can see they have a different orientation. This one is, you know, this is the right way up here. If you look at the other one, it's sideways. And what I do with the tank drawing is the PDN, like it may say new old school, like NOS underscore tank one PDN. But what I do is, so we're looking at the Salmon's trucking skin here. So what I do is I just go and make all these different layers in here. So if we look at a diamond, so this is for pre-may equipment. If I, the new old school stripe, so that's the gold pinstripe. That's for new old school. If we look at the STC, Salmon's Transport, it's got that pinstripe. The skull, this is for the Lost Arroyo Ranch. And the Black Swan, of course, is for Black Swan. So you just put the text on the tank because it already has the swan up on the side of the cab. So, and then what you do here, you would go eliminate the background, and then you go File, Save As, then you choose DDS. And now you've got NOS tag DDS. You just change the NOS to BS for Black Swan. It's probably in here amongst all this stuff someplace, but BS tank DDS, there you go. BS tank one DDS. So let's cancel that. And I think we're done with that. So that's a tank. So you have things like interior parts. So here is the dash. So this is the dashboard, and you'll see in the STC version of the 352, I've got some of these. You can see the STC label on the dashboard here and there. And once again, you clear off the background and save it as a DDS. And I'm going to show you where all of that goes in Mod Studio 2 here shortly. That's the whole object of the game here. And then I do things like, oh, that's a transparent label that I made, so I can just drag this and put it on a painted surface. I also have this one. If I wanted to just trim around here, do anything I want with it, it just, you know, gives me the ability to do something with this logo. And this is, unfortunately, I had to draw this. Like, so I took the actual STC logo, and then I made my own over top of it. And then to make a transparency, you inverse select it. So, you know, you use your, this is all drawn, but if you were to take your magic wand, just leave it at 50% there, and we were to come in here and hit shift. Oh, we got the wrong, we wanted this one here, did we? Nope, this one. So we hit shift and then select something here. We could take all of that out. We could delete that. And now that's missing, and it becomes what you have in your transparency, where it's been cut away. And it's kind of, yeah, it's, you can make all kinds of cool stuff with paint.net. Anyway, let's get back to here. You can also see in here what I've done for my unit number. This is my personal skin. What I've done, so I've made a cutaway of my 467. So to do that, you put 467 on the same layer that you have your paint, so, or the white base color paint, you put 467 on, and then you cut it away. And you, when you cut it, it's removed. And now this white acts like a mask. And when you paint this truck blue, 467 is going to be painted in the same blue as the truck. Yeah, that's kind of a cool little trick. I don't know why the back of the cab isn't showing up down here. I wonder why that is. Did I put it on a different layer? No. I just don't get it. You can see all of my transparent stickers and stuff here. Oh, the back of the cab's over there. Yeah, I was thinking of the K100. Sorry, its back of the cab is down here. And you can see the salmon's here is a cutaway as well. So it gets painted in the color of the truck. So when the truck color gets painted, zoom. So anyway, that's kind of a cool little thing you can do. It's not related to advanced skinning in any way. It's just a little tip I threw at you. So let's go to Mod Studio 2 and see how all of this comes together in an advanced truck skin. So bring up Mod Studio 2. And I have here, I've put it on the accessories tab to begin with because it takes this rotten old CPU forever to bring this up. So I just started here. And we can go back and look at the how to set the truck up once we get out of here, because I didn't want to waste your time watching this thing try and load. So we'll go and look at the truck, the basic setup, you know, the skin or skins. And we're also going to, after I do this one, I'm going to show you a really advanced skin, way more stuff in it than this one. And I'll do a reset. I'll stop the video. I'll bring all of the drawings up, and then I'll just show you quickly. And then I'm going to show you how to do a trailer, like an SCS trailer, with all the combinations. So you can paint, you know, any combination you make in the game, you know, triple, B double, turnpike double, Rocky Mountain, single, you know, 45, 48, 53, 28, 32, whatever you want to pull will be painted. And I'll show you how to do that too in this little video. Anyway, let's start here. So this is black. It just says old school paint black. And what this isn't even for the salmon skin, but it works here because the game doesn't read beyond the skins. So when you have the same accessory name here as I would use on the old school truck to get something painted black, it doesn't care. But if the names in here are the same in your skin and you use the same DDS name, the game's going to choke on it. So under accessories, it's fine. So what this is a blank black DDS. Now, what this does is there's things on this truck, like the salmon's truck. I want it to be painted blue or whatever color you want. But if you don't pick certain things on this truck in particular and make them a color, they're going to be painted to like a psychedelic thing. You're going to have pieces of this bit of the paint job painted over the air filter. You might end up with something over here on a fuel tank. You might end up with the grill with 467 on it, whatever. Because the being an advanced skin, all of the accessories and components that make up the rest of the truck, like the frame, the fenders in the back, all the bits, the air filter, the battery boxes, they all are just going to grab their paint from somewhere in here on the body. It makes a mess. And so you have to do an advanced skin. So your body of the truck is separate. That's going to be on skin. We'll get to it. All the accessories that you want to have black, you've got to go in here and make them black. And when you see this truck, it's kind of a nightmare. Like, look at how many bits there are you have to go through. So let's see what we made black. So the steps are black. What else? Trailer cables and hoses, all that stuff's black so they don't get all psychedelic. Anything else in there? Looks like it. So let's go down to the next thing. What do we got here? STC tank. So that was that tank thing we're looking at. We're looking at the fuel tanks. So this is tank with no one after it. So that's the one basic tank. So you'll go down here in your list and you're going to see somewhere or other we got tank with no one, just the tank. There it is. Paint. Now, what we've chosen here, I wanted to have some options. So I didn't do aluminum and paint, chrome and paint. I just did paint and chrome tank. So paint, aluminum tank, and paint tank. So those three tank options are going to come up with this on them. Because, and the background on these is blank. So the background on the tank is going to be the color you chose to paint the truck. So if you're painting this truck dark blue, the tanks are going to be dark blue, but they're going to have fuel tank labels in the stripe. So that's groovy. Okay, that's all that we had in there. So you have to cipher through all of this till you find that. And we'll go down to the next one. What do we got here? So tank one. And we go down and find the tanks in here. You'll see that we have tank one and not tasty. Tank one. And I used the same three options. And you'll see chrome and paint tank and paint whatever. They're not selected because they're a different tank than tank one. That was the other one. It's just above this in the load order here. Or the order. Now the battery box, this is a blank. And you could put something on it, on the battery box if you wanted. I didn't because it just gets busy. A little too busy maybe. But so I chose, I wanted these to be painted body color. So whatever you paint this color here that's not painted in the DDS, the main body, whatever that color is going to paint the battery box that same color. Now what else have we got here? Battery box one. So that was a different battery box. Oh yeah. And so you got to go in here and match it up. Tell the paint program that, or the Mod Studio 2, that this box one is going to get painted, once again, whatever color you paint the truck. And what do we got here? This is frame stripes. So stripes on the frame. So you got to go through here. And there's, so yeah, just pick all this stuff. There's so much frame parts here. It's crazy. But anyway, you've got the, if you've got the templates for this truck, you'll see you've got a ton of templates. And I don't know if I have a frame one open. But anyway, once again, you've got to select what you want painted. The background isn't painted. If you wanted these stripes and you wanted black fenders, your DDS, you would make it with a layer of black underneath the stripes. Save it as a DDS. So this would be black with these stripes. And you'd paint your fenders black with stripes. Pretty simple. Same with the rear fenders. Same thing right there. Here's filter 01. And I found that the reason it's way down here is I found that it was getting painted weird too. So once again, filter 01 is going to get painted the color of the body because there's no color in here. It's just a blank piece. And I also found that I needed to make separate ones. Like quite often, all of the parts you want painted body color, you just put them on a blank DDS, and it didn't work with this truck. So I made the ones I found weren't getting painted right their own. The frame, so frame parts that you want painted blue. Or, whatever color you paint the truck. You have to go in here and select them. And just put a blank DDS in there. What do we got here? Salmon's blank DDS. And this is all the rest of it that you wanted painted. So this is all the stuff that I wanted to have painted. So in other words, this is going to be everything that wasn't listed on any of those other DDSs here. So anything that didn't get listed here that was getting funny marks on it or a little stripe, then a little bit of leftover paint from something, like you had a little plate, a little part of the frame, a little part of a fender bracket, anything that looked weird, just throw the whole works at it. So that's how the accessories thing works in this instance for this truck. Of course, you select, I always like metallic for most things. Now here we go to the skins. And in this case, there's going to be one skin. And that's this one. And that's this right here. Oh, we've got a, there. That's that right there. So we'll get back to here. And pretty simple. Like, I mean, you know, Icon is in this case, this isn't the one I published because the published one has a proper icon there. In basic, you just give it your name and whatever. If you're going to do an advanced truck skin, this skin internal name can't be more than 10 characters. And if it's a simple skin, it could be 12. So I would usually have an underscore right there. And then if I'm doing multiple skins, like one for me and one for Darren, or one for MacGyver for Steam, I do Dan for me. It would be, Recon would be REC or something. MacGyver would be MCG. That's how I do my skin names. And then the skin name here is the one that displays when you look at it in the paint shop and under the truck. Oops. Sorry, go back here. Where was it? Skins. No. Oh, am I not seeing it here? Oh, sorry. Manifest. So here's the one. This is what shows up in your mod folder when you're looking at it in your actual mod folder where all the SCS files are. And I like to put the names of the person or MacGyver or whoever at the end. So if I got a whole bunch of salmon skins, they're all going to be in the same place. If I put my name in front of it, it's going to categorize them by my name. So that's why the difference. So Dan at the end on mod name and on the skin name, that's fine because to have your name at the front because or under basic here. That's going to show up in the paint shop that way. And you got a lot less stuff to look through and it's, handy. All right. So that's it for advanced skinning this truck. And what we'll do is I'm going to show you a trickier truck and then we're going to do trailers. So I'll be right back. All right. We're back. And this is a really crazy skin. This is a skin that probably, probably took longer to do than the Night Move skin. And then the Night Move skin was, maybe I'll show you just a quick little blurb at the end about why that one was so difficult and it being a simple skin. But let's have a quick look at this. This is the Blueprint Modding Kenrith 521 Needle Nose Montana Express skin. And this is an advanced skin and it's got a lot of moving parts here, so let's check it out. So what we can see here is the body, and this is the basic body. This is what's going to get painted straight away on the without any additions. But if you don't do, once again, like we've done with the previous skin where we had all the accessory parts painted individually or separately, you're going to end up with trouble. And or in trouble. And so just a few things to point out here before we get going. What I do when I want to center something, I'll put these X's on the template. So those should be on the template layer. And what they do is help me find center. So center on a fuel tank, center on the back of a cab, whatever. If there's nothing to give me center, I'll put the X's on it right on the template. And next time I use a template, it's there and helps me out. So pretty straightforward here. We've got the air filters are painted on the main template on this one, which is kind of nice. It's good. Don't have to do it separately. Everything else, one template. These big black things, this is, I kind of figured out where on the running board, like this is a vintage truck and it has running boards down here that would run along here. That's the flat surface. So I just put black on them to make it look like there's a rubber pad. Because I thought it looked pretty bad with this completely paint. It just doesn't look realistic. So added some paint there. And once again, it's like, everything's on a layer. There's the air cleaners on a layer. The running board's black. Script's on its own layer. So ME cab rear. That's the paint. ME pass paint. Driver's paint. And so it's all individual. There's the stickers on that layer. It's just the IFTA, as everything else is on the sleepers on this truck. So let's get into why this is so crazy, this truck. So here, let's see, which sleeper is this? This is the 34-inch. So this is the Kenworth sleeper. And that's one of the options. So it's its own. So you can see it's the same template. But if you went to look at and paint it here, it doesn't show up, or it doesn't show up correctly. You've got to make it on a different layer. So you use the same template to do the sleeper. But it's a whole new item under accessories on the advanced truck skin. And we'll get to that when we look at Mod Studio 2. And so you put the stickers where you want them on this one. On this, copied this from the net, you know, got myself a Kenworth logo to put on the sleeper. It's kind of cool. It looks kind of good when you get fairly close to it. It's got that little shine to it, a chrome outline. I'll show you logos, like what I do. I have a folder for logos. But anyway, kind of pirated or peeled off online. So that's the Kenworth sleeper. There's a couple Mercury sleepers. And I can't remember which one I saved it as. It'll be saved in the DDS. Anyway, they're different. So we can see let's look at the second one too. You can see how this, when I saved it as a DDS, I picked out the parts I wanted. So they're not the same. Each of these, when I get to the DDS stage, and you have to kind of figure it out which one's going to be what. And if you're really curious, I could probably show you for this truck in a different video, but this truck was complicated. And the crazy thing is like, you know, one side of the sleeper, and there's two different size sleepers here, and you save it as one size. So here we take various things out of it, and well, there's the stickers. But so this would be one sleeper. Put that back. That would be a different sleeper, and that would be yet another sleeper. And you save what? And anyway, it's pretty nuts. It's pretty nuts. And to get this to line up at the back, that has to line up. The front bit has to line up with the front of the on here. So you have to make it line up here. And so there's lots of back and forth, lots of messing around to try and get this just right. These little panels here, they took forever. So anyway, you got to make all of these separate drawings, all these separate DDSs. And let's go into Mod Studio 2 now and see where they show up. So under accessories, we've got that standard thing. Well, what did we want to be black? And so let's look and see what we made black with this straight black item here. DDS. Oh, hose tubes. Okay. Anything else? Just hose tubes. That's it. That's all we made black on this kind of elaborate. Okay, so here we go. This is the Kenworth. So Montana Express, K for Kenworth, Dan. This is the little 34-inch sleeper. So let's go find that in here. Look at all the items once again. Oh, there we go. Kenworth 34-inch sleeper. So we had to select all these options. Anything that was Kenworth sleeper, we put them in. And so you can see, as we saw in our drawing over here, there it is as PDN form before we made it a DDS, the stickers, everything, it's all there. And so that is turned into its own drawing. As this drawing here, the main drawing, is what ends up here under the skins. And that secondary one, using the same big honkin' template, is your 34-inch sleeper. Let's go down, see what we got here. Fenders. So see this, I'm just taking that from could be anything, another DDS from probably a different truck that I wanted to make them whatever truck color. So this is going to paint any fenders or anything I choose, rather, in this list, just to be painted body color, whatever I paint the body. So it's a lot of stuff. So I've asked for all of this stuff to be painted body color here. And the name of this DDS doesn't matter. It could be blank. Could be, you know, I love aliens. I don't know. As long as you got room to put it in. Everything you want painted. Standard lights. Like this is the headlight pods. Like the shell for the headlight. Toolboxes and everything. So you wanted them painted. Okay, fair enough. Let's go down. Now we get to a Mercury sleeper. This is, we'll look in here and see which one I actually made it. Oh, it's just straight Mercury sleeper, so it's not going to be the, and see, this is the thing with these guys when they don't all label things the same. Some are really well labeled and some aren't. And this is kind of like Mercury sleeper. And we'll go to the next sleeper. So that's a smaller sleeper. This is a bigger sleeper. Oh, which way does that go? Yeah, this is the bigger one here. And let's see what he calls it here. It's probably just called Mercury sleeper again. Yeah, but you have to figure out which one's which. So if we look on the other one, it was probably the one above. Or sorry, that's below. Okay, Kenworth 34K Kaiser. That's the air conditioning unit. Is Kaiser. Camera 34 Mercury. So let's go down here and see what we got. Yeah. See the difference? So you got to figure it out yourself. Like one of the things I do sometimes is I'll make some test drawings and I'll just put a big number, like a text. I'll put number one, number two, number three, number four on various things in the template. So I'd go over here and I would put a big one on here. Put a big two on here, three here, and a four, five, whatever, and put a six or seven on these to find out what they are. You can put an eight or nine, 10, 11, and then you do it as a DDS, and then you put it on the truck. You put the truck in the game. You take your camera, your iPhone, your phone, whatever you got, and you take pictures of the screen of what the various things where they came out, and you'll find that sometimes the number two will be backwards, sometimes it'll be right way around. And this is a good tip for John Ruta's stuff. Don't use number one, and don't use number eight. Use numbers that will show reversed as reversed, because he's got a lot of stuff. Don't use a six or a nine, because sometimes they're flipped upside down. You never know, so you got to use a number that will show, you'll recognize that it's flipped inverse or, you know, rotated. And so number stuff, throw it on the truck, look at it. It'll help you learn what all the parts are. And that's how I figure out these sleepers. Anyway, let's go back here. Those are the Mercury sleepers. What else we got? Tanks. So that's a little wee tank label there. And we could probably see where we got that in here somewhere. Tanks. And if we look at the main drawing, there's the tank right there. But we had to work on this thing as its own individual drawing. And then, and you could do the brackets if you wanted here. I just left them body color. But this is where you'd put your labels. And you'd save that as a separate DDS, and it goes in where we're just looking there. That's its own little DDS with that great big template all gone to waste behind it. And this is a tank. Oh, sorry, this is going to be, let's just make sure I'm not saying anything wrong. I'll see what I made this one. Oh, yeah, louver's closed. So I found that if I use this color here, if you don't paint the louvers, they're going to have stripes all over them from the paint job, just like we're saying with the KSW. So you have to paint the louvers on this truck. So I found that this color here looks almost like chrome when you put it into the game. And this is lights painted. And this is a blank DDS, so it's going to be painted body color. And what else do we have here? Tanker. So this will paint this 521. You can make it a straight truck with no fifth wheel, and it has options. One of them is a big fuel tanker on the back. So you put a blank in here, and it makes it a body color fuel tank on the back of the truck. So that's the 521 and all the goofy stuff you have to do. I wanted to show you also this. So we look at this drawing here. See these blanks here. Watch this. So this one puts black here and here. So that's your mesh for your grill. And if you don't, you're going to end up with artifacts painted in here, and you're going to have open louvers, and the grill mesh behind it is going to show, you know, some body color here, some orange stripe over here, whatever. So this is another aspect of this truck that was tricky. And once again, this is where you'd put a number on here. Put a big 2 here, big 3 there, whatever. Put it in the game, see what it says, see what it does. Kind of get a handle for the size of it. And this DDS is made by taking this main drawing, putting black here on its own layer, and then pulling it out. Let's see if I have that. No, I did the tank there. That was done on a separate layer. That's why this isn't. See, you wouldn't have this enabled when you make the DDS for this main file. You turn that off. What else? I think that's about it on this one. So you're going to want to stick around for this, because I'm going to show you the trailer thing, and this is completely different than what we've done here in terms of the skins, because as we've seen here, we've got one skin. Now we're going to go do a trailer. You can see we have a whole bunch of skins, and then the accessories, but you can use the same accessories on each skin. So it's kind of cool. And I'll give you an idea how to do the trailers really easily. So I'll end this segment here, and I'll be back. All right, we're back for round 3, the big enchilada. So this is, hopefully you find this one interesting. And I didn't mention, but I usually paint the background a sort of soothing color, because it's kind of glaring looking at all these checkers all the time. So I do that just to get that out of the way, and I can, it's easier on the eyeballs. And so let's start with I'm going to show you how to do a bang up job of being able to paint all of the trailers and all the combinations in one mod, and using advanced skinning. And so here we go. Here we got the Night Moose skin, and this is kind of cool. It's one of my favorites. Like I kind of like the shading effect here. And what I've done is this fill here, this is metal flake. And what I did was I just took an image of metal flake from the internet, brought it into the game, or into the drawing program. And I you can't cut it and stretch it, paste it and stretch it, because it just blurs it out. So what you have to do is, like, I'll show you what I mean. Like, typically, you can grab something like this. That's this one here. You can copy it and do this and drag it. But, makes a mess. So you can't do that. You have to copy it, move it over, paste it, move it over. And it worked out pretty good. I'd like to redo it sometime with a finer metal flake, like I did in my final version of the El Halcón for Ruta's 389. Like, that's, that's my personal favorite. I love that paint job. And this is the Night Moves 389. I was going to show you quickly. I'll show you at the end why that took days and days to do. But anyway, here we are. We've got a 53-foot trailer body. So I've got NM underscore 53, Night Moves 53. And just really quickly, I'll show you how I organized the folder for that. Got to go to trailers. That's SCS box. Do I have it as Night Moves? Yeah, here. So you can see I have all these folders, 28, 32, 45, 48, 53. And what they're all going to have in them is the trailer folder, or the trailer skin of each one. And I start with the, close that. I start with the 53. And if we hide that, you're going to see that it's really accurately placed on the template. So what I can do when it comes time to put this on the next skin, I would do this. Let's just show you really quickly. Go to mod or trailers, SCS box, templates, and we'll grab a body 53. We'll put that here. We'll go here. And what I can, oh, wait a minute. I didn't want 53. I wanted 48. Hold on. Body 48. And I work my way down one trailer size at a time. So I'd start here. This is the left side. I would copy that. So copy, go over here. Oh, come on. Bring this one up and create a new layer. It would be the paste. Oh, I got to change the canvas size. Sorry, I make my drawings really big. Look at this one, 16384 by 8192. So that's going to be four times this. So we go image, resize, percent, 400. And the reason I make them big is the detail. You get really nice detail. Skins look sharp and crisp. They look good. And I try to not go too nuts so that it ruins the file size. So now we've got that on here. And this is basically what I do. And then I realize, you know, I kind of want to move this night moves down. So you could just go like this with your tool there and grab a bunch of black down here because you're going to copy and move it, not cut. Because if you cut, then you got to fix the black paint. So copy, move, and you can just drag this down here. See, if you went too far, you're going to uncover that at the right. But that's why I grabbed a bunch of black, because if I wanted to move it this far, that's already covered. So that's, so you take the 53 skin, you turn it into a 48, down to a 45, a 32, and you just edit it as you go. So we'll kill that. We don't need it. Don't save. This skin right here, this is the 28, which is the double or the triple or the lead trailer of a B double or the pup on a Rocky Mountain double. And it's a different scale altogether. So you got to just, you know, this one's a little work. It's more work than all the others. So just so you know. But anyway, that's what we do. That's how we get everything going. Now here's Arrow. So we're going to see a whole bunch of Arrow packages in. This is the left arrow with hole. So that's the hole for the, to fill the reefer unit's fuel tank. And it's backwards. Dang it. So once again, if you get confused, this is where you put numbers on stuff. Like if you put a number 7 or a number 4, number 5 on this, and if you're curious, it'll, and then you can keep templates. That, or if you have a body of work, you can look back at them and say, well, is which way did that template go? And what you can do is you could take this template, 53-hole left PDN. It's probably the same one I use all the time, and then I just do my new layer on it. And let's see if we have something else. Yeah, look, there's the fuse for Pogo. There's Pogo. So, I mean, I've used that before for a different truck, and then you just do this, hide that. Do that, save as the Pogo arrow PDN. But in this case, we made it night moves. So save your work. Like you can save a PDN as anything. Like you don't have to save it as the 53 hole left PDN. When you save it as a DDS, you give it the new name. Anyway, so that's, and then we've got things like, that's the front deflector. Of a, oh yeah, the reason you can't see anything behind there, it's all hidden. So that's the front of the trailer. Here's the rear trailer door with arrow. And you can see there's a little jog in it here because it's not the same scale. And if you're coming down here like on an old school skin, it's off down here too. And this bit down here is the top of the arrow. So it's painted roof color. So if you look at this gray, that's the roof of the trailer. And I always make them gray because, not always. I didn't do that initially. But then again, I'm learning as I go. we got a DDS. We turned that into a PDN. We made it a DDS. Let's go look at Mod Studio and see where we go here with this. So we're using just trailer skin. I think there's simple trailer skin, but this is straight trailer skin template. If you use a simple trailer skin, you need that for things like the Fruhoff tanker from Harvin. That's where you need a simple trailer skin. What else? There's a few others. But if you use a straight trailer skin, you'll see you have images here instead of skins like we did with the truck. But this is skins. And here's the accessories. So what you do a single mod and you call it, for the initial skin, you call it what you want the skin package to be named, not the first skin. So this isn't going to be SCS box trailer pack, or rather 53 foot. It's going to be the name of the package, which is different than if you're doing a single skin or a truck. So just bear that in mind. Is you'll have a name that will say 53 foot trailer if you put that here in your mod folder, but it belies the fact that you've got all the trailers in here. So we go to trailer skin, we go to images. I shouldn't have clicked off there because this little PC is going to grunt for a while. Man, to get these images up. Yeah, I really got to upgrade the CPU on this thing. Man, oh man. This was my gaming rig when I first got ATS. And I soon realized how out of date it was. It was 2 years ago. So I built a hot rod for the gaming rig, but this one needs updating. So here we got the skins. So here's our 53. It's set as a dry van 53, an insulated 53, a refrigerated 53. We go down, we did the 48 one, same, so 48, 48, 48. And we just work our way down, 45, 32, 28. So all of these are under images. So instead of putting them all down here, trailer skin, trailer skin, trailer skin, you do them all here. And this way, you don't have to, whatever you do when you go in to start configuring your trailers in the workshop, you're just going to get whatever combination you put together. If you have the paint job selected, they're all going to pop up with the paint job. You don't need to go and say, okay, now that I built this, paint that trailer with this 28, paint the 45, and give me a Rocky Mountain double. You just build the trailers and the skins pop up, which I find kind of handy. Now accessories. This is where all that arrow and doors come in. And we were looking at the door. That was this one. And same with the front arrow. There's one for, this is the standard door with arrow. There's one for the standard door. There's a drawing for the roll-up door. And there's the same drawing you use for the roll-up door can be used for the roll-up door with the cargo lift. So yeah, just bear in mind, there's not just this one. We're going to see that when we go back into Mod Studio 2. In here, we'll go to accessories. And this will take a little while to load because there's a bunch of them too. Yeah. Man. So we got to light a fire under this PC. There we go. And I even rebooted it before I started this little demo thing here because it's so bad that if I don't reboot it every now and then, it just gets confused and clogged up. So our first painting is just black. And what it does is it, because night moves, you want everything to be black on the front of the trailer. And I guess I could have showed you an old school trailer or something, because it would have the stripes that come across it to paint it. And that's a lot of work to get that scaled right, to get it to come across and look right. But, you know, that's another issue for another day if we needed to get into it. But that would be a long video, how to really do that crazy stripes on these trailers. So anyway, that's for a cooler, right? And that should be it, just a cooler. And there's different ones, chrome cooler, cooler, and turbo cooler. So let's see what we've got next. So trailer front painted and with wind deflector. So I put the, that was this one right here. So with this night moves, I placed that so that it would end up right on the front of the wind deflector. So I could use this skin on both of these items. If it was going to be different, I would have to have a separate, another tab, another item down here, right there for that one. Anyway, next down, we have, what have we got? Roll-up door with lift gate. So that works on both of those. And we'll go down. And the reason it's like this is this template is about this long. And what's down here is going to get painted the green that I like for that skin. This is that main stripe that goes all the way to the back and around the back. In the center of the hardware latching mechanism goes right through the center there. So that's night moves. And this is a drawing about a big. Front and rear. What? Front and rear. Uh-huh. Standard door. Oh, yeah. Okay, that's just a standard door. Oh, this is the, yeah, that's my folder structure. Sorry, getting a brain fart there. Standard door. That's that standard door with arrow we're looking at with deflector. What do we got next? Oh, yeah, that's the roof of the arrow. That's the top of those flaps there. So it matches the roof of the truck. What do we got here? This is going to be... Okay. Painted side skirts left and right. And you probably can't make it in there. I don't see it. I thought I had night moves on there someplace. Maybe it just doesn't show up. And so what I did, oh yeah, I didn't put any logo on this one. And so what that does is it allows me to just select them all. So I can just go through and it's all the arrow for the left side of the truck. And where's my one for the other side? Oh, up here. No. Painted side skirts, right side. Why don't I have... Something's missing here. I wonder if I somehow deleted that after, since I've actually done the... painted side skirt, right side. Oh, left side and right side. They're right there. Sorry. Yeah, the right side is a lot simpler because it doesn't have the hole. You see all of these ones with hole? That's that hole for filling up the... refrigeration unit's fuel tank, right? That's what I'm confused. So that just paints all your side panels. And if we had been doing the one with, I'm surprised I don't have the night moves on there. I guess I just didn't go that. It is a lot of work to do the separate ones with the. If you're going to put like pogo on the side of the night moves or. What's simpler is if you look at my, which one? New old school and old school have just that symmetrical script. And they're pretty easy to do because you don't have, you know, if it flips it backwards, big deal. It's the same. It looks the same. But if you put writing on it, or if you put like the black swan skin, that would have been a good example to pull up because the black swan arrow, the swan would face backwards if you didn't put it on the right way. And so you have to, like we saw with that side skirt. Where was that side skirt? Was it here? Yeah, so you would have to have the swan facing backwards on this side, on the left, to make it face right. It's just pretty nuts. Anyway, Yeah, side skirts can be a pain, but that's not why we're here. We're just here to show you the overall story. And I think we've covered it. I don't know if there's anything more I need to add, but this is the whole, you know, the way you use accessories. And with the trailer, it's quite different than the truck. And just this business of putting all of your images over here in this tab instead of individual skins makes it really nice when you're in the workshop building the truck. So I just thought I'd put that there. Now you have the option, which you can do if you don't want all the skins to show up when you're looking at a building of 53 single trailer and you see all of those other skins in the paint shop under it. You can do a single 53 and add a whole new skin for the 48, the 45, 32, and 28 over here. But in here, we have images. If you want a Rocky Mountain double, you'll have to put a 45 and you'll have to put a 28 under it. If you want to build a, I think the Turnpike double requires two 45s for some reason. It won't just do it by default. But I think the doubles and triples will work off of one skin. But I find this easier. Just put them all here. And you'll get it all done. And it's one-stop shopping. Anyway. Oh, I was going to show you one other thing. That's to go in here. I'll go open. Trucks. I just want to show you why this truck was so difficult and why I was so happy when it finally came out. Which one of these is it? That's the color one. It was here. Oh, which one of these is it? I can't. Is it this one? Yeah, it's this one. I want to show you something. So this truck, as you know, has the stripes going across the custom fenders. I didn't do it for the standard fender here. I did it for the big one. But look at the weird angles. These aren't at the same angle. That one's a little different than that one. They're a little different widths, and they're pointing in different directions. But look what happens across the top of the fender. Like these curves here. Because they're coming off the fender on an angle that you don't see here. And you get these curves so that when you look at it in the skin on the truck, it's straight. It's just, that looks simple enough. But just doing this, these are different widths. This lines up with that, that lines up with that, that lines up with that. And these appear to be straight on the truck. And man, oh man, that's a lot of messing around. And what I do is I build one side and then I'll copy it to the other side. These black lines, because the truck is painted black, those black bits here, there's a bit of litter behind that I left somehow on the template showed up in the truck. So those are like, just hide that so when it's painted. But that skin looks simple enough, but holy man, that took a long time to do. And I'd like to do it for more trucks, but I got to be mindful of the amount of time I spend doing stuff because I just don't have enough of it. Anyway, well, there you go, guys. So that's the advanced skinning tutorial. And if you have questions, put them in the comments and whatever. And as always, appreciate your subscriptions and your patronage and. Well, not that I'm a patron or do patron or whatever it is, but you know what I mean. Your fellowship, let's call it that. Anyway, thanks so much. Take care. We'll catch you on the next one. Bye for now.